সুখম ঐন্দ্রিয়কম দৈত্যা দেহ যোগেন দেহিনাম সর্বত্র লভ্যতে ইয়স্মাদ যথা দুঃখম অযত্নতঃ। সুখম ঐন্দ্রিয়কম দৈত্যা দেহ যোগেন দেহিনাম সর্বত্র লভ্যতে ইয়স্মাদ যথা দুঃখম অযত্নতঃ। শিশিল ভক্তি সিদ্ধান্ত সরস্বতী গোস্বামী ঠাকুর প্রভুপাদ to enjoy very cheap kama, for very small, very cheap kama, those jivatma, they are committing suicide, they are going to lose their opportunity, golden opportunity, very cheap kama, useless. For that reason, one jivatma fight with another jivatma. They like to kill each other, develop some hostility. This way, they are busy with some material objective. They cannot reach up to that point. Divine objective is so high, so excellent. Common people cannot see at all. To satisfy their very cheap karma, very cheap, they are going to commit suicide, they are going to lose all golden opportunity, you see. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada crying. They cannot understand the real meaning of their life. Very dangerous thing. Somebody asking that Maharaj, sannyasi, brahmachari, they should live in forest. Why they are living in society? Why they should live in forest? They should meditate on Supreme Lord, this, that. But they forget that Prahlad Maharaj told one nice thing. Prahlad Maharaj is not selfish. Prahlad Maharaj is not selfish. That's why Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Prayeno deva munayu sabhi mukti kama maunam charanti vijanina pararthan nishtha naitana vihaya kipanana vimumukshayeko nanyam tadasya saranam bhramato nupase. Prahlad Maharaj speaking. Prabhu, I am not so selfish that I can fly to a very lonely place and meditate. I am not so selfish that I can think only about myself. I am thinking about all bonded souls here in this society. Basic objective of Gaudiya Math nobody can understand. Anyhow, Gaudiya Math like to deliver all those bonded souls. Gaudiya Math, his objective is very high, common people cannot understand. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, actually, I am not going to a solitary place in the forest. Most of those Rishi Munis, they are going to forest to meditate on Supreme Lord. But I am thinking about those bonded souls, those asura balagas, those boys, asuras. They have no chance to get free of this material torture. I am always thinking about them. And I know it very well. There is no other way except your mercy. Except your mercy, there is no other way, no alternative. I know it very well. At the same time, I know it very well, your mercy always coming through a devotee. Mercy of Supreme Lord not coming directly to you. Always coming through pure Guru Vaishnava. Some people, they are envious, having some envious attitude asking, why those sannyasis, brahmacharis staying in this society? They should leave. They should go to forest and stay there. Then Param Pujyavad Keshav Goswami speaking, Actually, he was suggesting that Sadhu Guru Vaishnava should go to forest for their own bhajan. But actually, those Sadhu Guru Vaishnava staying in this society, there is only one reason. What is that? In those forests, there are some ferocious animals there. And in this society, more ferocious an animal there than that forest. I know in forest, there is ferocious animal. I have to live with very big struggle, we'll have to do. But you don't know, man, come on. In this society, there is more and more ferocious, you know, animals staying. They are more than those animals. Those animals can stop up to their gratification, I mean food. But these animals, they are not satisfied. They like to fight all the time, small reason, you know. Anartha, when I started discussing about anartha, many people feel disgusted, but they don't know why. They cannot go up to that point. Big problem. So actually, if we are always busy with this small thing, how we can observe Abhirbhav Thiti, Tirobhav Thiti of Guru Vaishnava? Prabhupada speaking, Abhirbhav, Tirobhav, with dissatisfaction of Ab, is not possible to observe. Abhirbhav, Tirobhav, if you like to take participate in Abhirbhav, Thiti, Tirobhav, Thiti of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, but it is not possible for you. If you are full of dissatisfaction all the time, no satisfaction inside your heart, then Abhirbhav, Tirobhav with Abhav. In Sanskrit we say Abhav. Abhav means dissatisfaction. Heart is not fulfilled. Actually, point is that Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Shukham Indriyakam Daitya Deho Yogena Dehi Nam Sarvatra Bhati Yatman Dathai Yatha Duksham Ayatnata. Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of those Asura Vayas Balaks. Oh my friends, you see, you like to get some satisfaction, enjoyment, huh? Right? But think over and again about this point. Each and every life, all Jivatma get in some sort of enjoyment. Maybe the mode is different. The enjoyment of a pig, baraha, is different. Your enjoyment is different. This much, nothing else. But all material enjoyment, everything material enjoyment. Without material enjoyment, nobody like to live in this material world. Why? They get some rasa. They get some enjoyment, rasa. I already told many times, there is direct rasa, indirect rasa. Direct rasa, indirect rasa. Annaya vyatir, annaya vyatirika abhyam. Any kind of rasa, maybe direct rasa, indirect rasa, I mean transcendental rasa or material rasa, all source coming, all source Krishna. Source is Krishna. Any kind of rasa coming to you, any kind of rasa coming to you, all coming from Krishna. Rasa Vaisha, I told you many times. So, oh Asura boys, my friends, in each and every life, you are going to get enjoyment. Shukham indriyakam daitya deho yogena dehinam. When you are getting this gross body, that's mean you are giving this gross body to enjoy. So that you go on enjoying, you try to find such a point when you can find satisfaction. Can you find? Is there any end point that up to that point your enjoyment done? Now you are satisfied? Nobody can speak. Up to now, nobody can speak this way, Maharaj. Not. they are not satisfied. In Bhagavatam, nice example given by Krishna, you see, if you like to add some clarified butter on fire, then fire go on, increasing fire. If you add some inflammable objective, yeah, there, oil, ghee, then you cannot expect that fire can extinguish, not at all. Not possible. Those sense organs, they are like mad dogs, mad jackal, mad dogs. Always they like to get some enjoyment. Always. They are never satisfied. That's why in front of Kapilji Maharaj, Devahuti told, I am fed up. I am just fed up. I wanted to satisfy those respective sense organs, but I am undone. I couldn't satisfy them. Prapanna andhyam tamaha prabhu. He prabhu. Now I am fallen into darkness, deep darkness. Who can deliver me? Prapanna andhyam tamaha prabhu. I am fallen into darkness. Who can deliver me? Prahlad Maharaj speaking, you see, in every life you can get enjoyment. Maybe the mood is different. Your enjoyment is different from which is, you know, very good for you, and that is bad for him. If I put you to into a minus 20 degree temperature, you can feel disgusted. But those people in Antarctica, they are always habituated. Minus 25, 30, they never think. They are habituated. This way actually, if you are satisfied in this situation, that man is not satisfied in this situation. If he is satisfied in this situation, you are not satisfied. It depends. A relative thing. Satisfaction and dissatisfaction, all relative thing, relative. No practicality there. All relative thing. Relative thing means, today is there, tomorrow vanishes. Today is there with you, tomorrow vanishes. That's why in Gita Bhagavan also speaking, you see, that this enjoyment going to stop, finish in your life. It's not permanent, all temporary. Any arrangement in this world, any arrangement in this material world, all permanent, temporary, not permanent, nothing permanent. So sukham indiyakam dachyadeho yogena dehinu sarvatalakta jasmat datha jathadukshama yatnataha. Nobody wants to put himself in sorrow. Nobody. But without any invitation, this kind of situation coming into your life to put you into misery, coming or not, you never expect. By according to your previous activities, sometime you are getting enjoyment, sometime you are put it into misery. It's a must. Nobody can avoid it. Nobody can avoid. So anyhow, we'll have to transcend. We'll have to transcend this material bondage and go up. Minimum thing. You have transcend this material bondage. Like escape velocity, you know, escape velocity in physics. Those, you know, satellite sent by rocket, liquid oxygen there. They are given calculated velocity. exact calculation. From launching pad, the rocket going up, after that, cutting all material bondage, then going and leaving this, you know, this, you know, satellite there. In exact orbit, according to previous calculation. Scientists, they are calculating such a way, velocity of Earth, I mean, and calculation so fine, that when from launching pad it is going with that satellite and living there in exact orbit. Exact orbit. So actually, you will have to cut this material bondage. It is called escape velocity. We call escape velocity so that you can get escape, go out. But nobody like to get escape velocity. They are busy with material thing, very small thing, always in fighting. How they can expect to reach Supreme Lord? How they can expect to reach Goloka, to get Nitya Seva? That day I was touching this point. Sometimes those big, big Mahapurush, those who are, you know, Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj, those who are always in Seva, deep into Leela, they sometimes giving us some advice, directly on that. That day I told you, you can remember, one man told, I am doing bhajan. You are alone? No. With my wife. Wife staying with you? No. Wife staying separate bhajan kuti cell. My different. And what about cooking? Cooking at a time. Together. Cooking together, no problem. Today what you take? Today I take brinjal fry, munge dal, everything describing. Babaji Maharaj laughing. You are so foolish. Why? How you can enjoy taking brinjal fry, munge dal, whereas this most auspicious thing, you know, missing in your life. Any man, any rich man, he's going to lose all his property. Can he take rest? Always crying. My everything gone. Ah, my everything gone. I am now, you know. Think about that. My Guru Padma used to, if somebody fighting, then Guru Maharaj call him. Sit, my boy. You will have to think over and again about that Tidandi Bhikshu. You know? You will have to think always about Tirandi Bhikshuk, you know, the situation of Tirandi Bhikshuk. Yes, sometimes you cannot remember all the time. We are not going to recite Bhagavatam. Be careful. We want to get all the principle of Srimad Bhagavatam in apply way, we want to see in applied form in our life. Bhajan mean? We like to get all principle of Bhagavatam get in applied form, Siddhanta. Not that I can memorize and speak in front of you and get clapping. Foolish. Not that. So Guru Padma used to say, you can, whenever you are very angry, whenever you are actually feeling disturbance, you should think about that Tidandi Bhikshu. You should increase your enduring power, tolerance. Tinadubi Sunij is not, you know, in philosophy. We'll have to apply in our own life. Tirandi Bhikshu, I can already at the time of Bhagavatam discourse, I was discussing about the Tirandi Bhikshu. The Tirandi Bhikshu actually was very miser, very close-fisted, never want to spend even 1 rupees. All his family members, wife, children, oh, you know, daughters, boys, they are going against him. They never like him. All relatives, they always like to avoid him. one day by the mercy of Supreme, by the mercy of Supreme Lord, everything gone. Very rich man. Dacoit came and take everything looted, and the king of that country came to take tax everything, due tax, everything looted, everything gone. He was just, you know, fallen into an ocean of misery. Started crying. Immediately he could shake up and thought, it must be the mercy of Supreme Lord. Because why I am developing some kind of detachment inside my heart? Anyway, when I am going to lose all my property, then all my family members, they are also going to leave me. They cannot like me because I have no property. I think it's good for me. It's the arrangement of Supreme Lord. So, he started singing nice song. That mantra is given to those who are taking actual sannyasis. Those who are taking sannyasis, for them, there is called actual mantra, very secret mantra, which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can find this one. Paratma nishtha matro besgrahan. Mukunda sevai hai sangsat taran. It's Bengali. You have enough time. You can learn Bengali. You can enjoy. Don't waste your time. Paratma Mahaprabhu speaking, when took sannyas, Paratma nishtha matro besgrahan. I have taken sannyas to serve Supreme Lord wholeheartedly. That is the motto of sannyas life. Not to enjoy, I am sannyasis, come, wash my lotus. Give garland, give pranami, not there. Oh. Srila Bhaman Goswami I used to say, last moment of life, I like to die unknown, unseen. Nobody can understand the mood of Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. So high class, detachment. That's why this kind of speech coming. I like to die unknown, unseen. I don't need your, you know, puja, lab puja, patishtha, nothing I need. Only to sing the glories of Supreme Lords, to sing the glories of Guru Vaishnava, is, you know, my seva. It's my seva. Guru Maharaj told, it is your seva. Vaishnava, all big will Vaishnava, Santa Goswami Maharaj, Tivikar Maharaj, Bhakti Nala Giri Maharaj, Bhakti Bhattal Sagan Maharaj, Bon Baba, who not? Nayanananda Baba, who not? Santa Goswami Maharaj, everybody is your seva. Not that you will have to earn some name and fame. Not that you will have to go here and there to earn name and fame. Not that. Preaching can be done automatically if you are established in the acharan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This much you will have to do, have to follow. So Tridandi Bhikkhu, you see, getting heavy punishment by the society. Somebody speaking all rubbish, somebody speaking all rubbish against him. Hey, he's a cheater actually. Now everything gone, he is a kapat. He has taken now sannyas vrata. He never mind. Let them speak. I will have to develop, increase my tolerance power. He is suffering and speaking. It is the arrangement of Sukrishna. It is the arrangement of Krishna, so I will have to suffer. The same thing Brahma told. Tatte anukampa su samikshamanam bhunjan eva atmakrita vipakam. This Brahma told. Same thing. Whom to blame? It is my own, you know, result of my own activities. So I am going to serve. whom to blame for that? The situation in which I am put it into, it is all my activities as a result of my activities. Whom to blame? Nobody to blame. Very nice discussion there. Very nice. Very nice. Apparently it seems he is responsibility. He is responsible for my suffering. Prabhupada says, no, nobody can put you into trouble. Apparently it seems he is putting you into trouble. Apparently it seems that he is responsible for my situation, this situation. Actually not that. Prabhupada speaking, nobody can put you into trouble. Nobody. Criticism, you see. Oti badam titiksheta. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Uddhava. Uddhava, when somebody is speaking all rubbish against you in front of you, you will have to suffer it. You will have to bear. Very nicely. Always you will have to think it's material sound. Material sound created, generate on material platform, finish. It's not transcendental sound. Why you give value? Why you are so angry? Huh? Bhagavan Sri Krishna saying to Uddhava, Uddhava, oti badam titiksheta. You will have to tolerate, you will have to bear. Don't speak anything if somebody insulting you. Krishna giving advice? Lecture? No. Krishna himself. Shishukal, 108 times. Continuously. As and when Shishupal started speaking, papa, papa, mama, mama, from that period, he started insulting Krishna. He is habituated. But still Krishna not speaking anything. A promise to, you know, maternal aunt. Up to this point I can tolerate, after that I will have to take step, due to some reason. 108. After that finished Krishna, you know, bless him. It is one kind of blessing. So this way actually, before Viraha Tattva, I am not mad to discuss this Viraha Tattva in front of some foolish people. Background should be there. First of all, you should think over and again your situation. You are Jivatma, you are na naham vipa, na cha narpatira na pivaishya na sudra naham burni na cha gyapatira na manasyati va kintu paddhan nikila paramananda purnamipadher purnamitadher gopibhatur padakamaryor dasa dasanu dasa. That is your topmost identity. If you can realize this thing someday, automatically detachment can come. No fighting can be there. No fighting. You can find everything already harmonized. You can find everything already harmonized, Maharaj. No problem. I was foolish. That's why I couldn't find this harmony. Actually, everything in this material world, everything harmonized. You will have to discover the harmony by the blessings of Guru Maharaj. By the blessings of Guru Vaishnava, you will have to discover this thing. This much. Bhajan means? Kite sadhya bhavaha, sadhana vidha, I can discuss this point. Only you will have to discover. Not that it is not there. It is already there. It is the natural instinct of your jivatma to serve Bhagavan. That's why Prabhupada told, what is bhakti, Prabhupada? We like to know in one line, what is bhakti? Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, bhakti is a natural function of your soul. Natural function. Now not natural. Unusual situation created by Maya. Surrounding situation cannot allow you to concentrate on your own objective. You cannot. What to do? That's why, first of all, background should be clear. To understand Viraha Tattva, today is the today is the actually disappearance day of Śrīla. Today is the disappearance day of Śrīla Śamana Goswami Maharaj. But I am going to discuss about Viraha Tattva. I think if I can discuss this Viraha Tattva, if you can realize this point, then I am very happy. Today my coming here is successful, if you can realize from heart. First of all, what do you mean by Viraha? Before discussing Viraha Tattva, you must know this vital point. What is that? Viṣaya sakta cittānam krishna avesha sudurataha. What this formula? You must remember. Don't try very one line. You must remember. Viṣaya sakta cittānam krishna avesha sudurataha. Viṣaya sakta cittānam krishna avesha sudurataha. In Sanskrit. Those who are busy with matter all the time, 24 hours, infinity prayer. Viṣaya sakta cittānam krishna avesha sudurataha. They cannot expect their mind can, you know, roam around the lotus feet of Krishna. Cannot expect. A butterfly roaming around this, you know, very nice lotus flower. It is nice fragment. Yes, at the same time, honey, huh? Have some reason. Why coming? Why not coming to you? Have some reason. So, in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Sri Chaitanya Padam Bhajo Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha Kathanchit Asrayat Yesam Sao Pitat Gandha Bhag Bhavet. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, Sri Chaitanya Padam Bhuja Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. Sri Chaitanya Padam Bhuja Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. Those who are coming around this lotus flower, I mean the lotus, you know, feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Nice smell coming, very nice. So all those butterflies, they are coming, running. No need of inviting any invitation letter. Without sending an invitation letter, only message, they are all coming. Only because they are going to get something concrete. So Chaitanya Charitamrita, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami ji, Sri Chaitanya Padam Bhajo Madhupebhyo Namo Namo. Those who are honeybees, I like to pay dandavat to them. Those honeybees, they are coming and hovering around the area of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lotus feet. Ah, boom. Why? They are going to get nectar. Sri Chaitanya Padam Bhajo Madhupebhyo Namo Namaha. Madhupebhyo. Plural number. Many butterfly. Madhupebhyo namo namo. Why? Kathanchit asrayat jesam. Somehow, some way, if I can take shelter of such a honeybee, I mean Guru Vaishnava, Paramahansa Guru Vaishnava, honeybees mean? Paramahansa Guru. What to speak about human being? A dog can also get the way open. Sargadaram apavritam. What sargo? Not heaven. Sargiyate yaso yasaha iti sarga. Sar means sargo. In Sanskrit, sarge. Sargayo. Sar means that transcendental planet, heaven, where all devotees, they are singing about this uttam slok. यत्रोत्तमसो गुणानुवादः प्रस्तूयते ग्राम्य कथा विघातः निसेव्यमान मनोदीनम मुमुक्षुर मतिम सतिम यच्छति वासुदेव. व्हाट नाइस. Yatrottama sloka gunanuvada. If you go on singing about the glories of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and devotees all the time, no problem. No problem can touch you. A solution of all problem is the glories of Supreme Lord. Sutasapungsam suchira samasya nan jo sasuri virtato tattat gunanu sabanam mukunda padaravinda hidayeshu yesham padaravinda hidayeshu yesham. Those devotees, they are catching the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and locking so that Mahaprabhu can go, cannot go out. They actually see Chaitanya Padambuja Madhubhebhyo Namo Namaha Katanchi Asraya Jesham. If I like to take shelter of such a honeybee, I mean Paramahansa, then what to speak about you and me? Huh? We are with human body. Even dog can get. Shivananda Sen dog? Getting the way out. Vaikuntha, gone. But you are not getting inspiration. Why? Because you are not following properly. Doing some aparad, knowingly, unknowingly. Due to aparad, passive condition is created. So you cannot realize this. Very nice thing. So, first formula is that, what is that? If you are busy with matter, you cannot expect your mind can hover around the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Vishaya Shakta Chityanam, whose heart is full of matter, enjoying mood, kama shakto, busy, to enjoy something. If slight disturbance of my kama, I can go against you and me, you and him. Vishayashakta Chityanam Krishna Vesu Sudurata. Where from you can get this kind of opportunity so that you can hover around? Because your heart is busy with matter, you cannot get chance. Now actually, before Viraha Tattva discussing Aima, I like to discuss this point that when detachment you can feel, at all if you have the connection with that matter, or man, any objective or any man, if at all any connection for a long time, you develop some, you know, Sangha. Sangha is one kind of Sangha. Secretly, you are doing Sangha. Not doing? That's why Prabhupada speaking, you like to fly to forest? Foolish? If you go to forest, there you are going to take your material mind with you in forest. Not you are keeping this mind with me. If you are going away in forest, then you are going to carry your mind with you. Eh? That mind is dangerous. Mano eva manusvanam. Karano sukho dukshayo. Your mind, material mind is responsible. So if you go away from this society and take shelter in a forest, how you can expect? Though externally you can find no matter is there, my soul, forest Maharaj. But inside your mind, like in water suspension, you know, in water, if you look by microscope, you can have different kind of suspension, germ and suspension. So in your, if you go to forest, if you like to meditate, you can find all matters there. Not practically in front of you, but it is there, mentally. Mentally mean, it is there. Mental existence of matter means you are with matter. mental existence, mental existence should be perfect. Perhaps you can remember, I told you one, you know, I heard nice, you know, one description from Guru Varga. Two friends have nice friendship among them, bosom friends. One day one friend speaking, that I like to go to, you know, watch the cinema. You know cinema? Huh. Picture, I like to go. One friend said, I cannot go. One nice sadhu coming here. I like to go. It's a golden opportunity. I must go and attend his speech. Then both of them, very nice friendship. One gone to cinema, one gone to sadhu to attend Harikatha. Then, you know, when he is watching cinema, his attention is totally there in sadhu. Ah, so nice sadhu. I forget, I miss. My friend suggested me. I missed this opportunity, and that man who is with sadhu, he is not hearing Harikatha, he is thinking, that nice picture. Actually, I missed this opportunity. Then though he is going to cinema hall, he is getting this, and he is getting opposite result. This is the actually condition. You can miss opportunity, though you are going to get this opportunity, still you can miss. Because of your foolishness. So that's why, actually, first point, actually, all our Guru Varga, I can discuss next day. All our Guru Varga, what to speak about Guru Varga? Even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the embodiment of Vipralambarasa. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the embodiment of portal of Vipralambarasa. Why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming? To show this, to prove it. In this material world, if we have some deep connection with some objective of man, if I am detached from that objective of man, I feel sorry for that. In material world, you can find, when your daughter is given away in marriage, you are crying, my daughter gone. Crying? Any friend is getting service in foreign country, you are staying in Calcutta, feeling separation. I know myself. I, 12 or 14 years back, or maybe 15 years, I cannot remember, I will have to check up. 9 books, I took responsibility to publish 9 books at a time. Okhla Press in Delhi, Okhla, Rukma Press. Is the disciple of Narayana Goswami Maharaj. It's a press business. Not that he's going to give me any donation. Not that. I went there because printing can be done very nicely. That time I was doing very attentively. I was doing proof reading there in the 3rd floor of Chaitanya Nagarium at Calcutta. Very attentively. Even I cannot see one ant passing there. So attentively. Now I couldn't understand, I couldn't see. One devotee came for a long time and standing in gate for a long time. I couldn't watch, I couldn't see him. He's watching me. After that, somehow when I watch him, oh Prabhu, you? Dandavati. He paid Dandavati. He's a Grihastha Bhakta. Very nice Bhakta. Then I asked him, you disciple of whom? Guru Padma. Amai Guru Padma Silsila Bhakti Rakha Siddhar Goswami Maharaj. Really. From which country you are? From this country. You are coming alone or your wife? When I speak about his wife, he bursted into tears. He started crying so heavily. So I was bound to embrace him, give some consolation. Why you are crying so? But you actually unknowingly remind me, very sensitive point. Why? My wife was so nice, so nice, so nice devotee. In our house, actually, all devotees used to come, take prasadam. We too used to cook, serve. One day, hepatitis B hepatitis B develop. I couldn't save. I was ready to spend all money that I have. I couldn't protect her. It's gone. Anyway, she is Vaishnava actually. But actually, be careful when father, mother, daughter, sister, you know, gone from our life in this material society, friends. We are expressing deep sorrow. We are crying. Sometimes we cannot bear. Even you can remember, I think 1 year, two years back, I told one history, very practical. One small boy, actually 4 or 5 years, his father went to Bhutan. Bhutan, you know? Bhutan, Nepal, Bhutan. From there, he got a lollipop. Very nice. For that boy. And that boy is very happy. All the time playing with pop. All the time. Very small, 4 or 5 years. Kindergarten, maybe he was submitted in kindergarten to learn something. But he don't like to go to school. My pop, you can come, no problem. He is there. After that one day, is that pop was very sick. Not speaking anything, not speaking, not barking, not coming, running, not playing with that boy. He was that boy was feeling disturbance. Why not playing? Well, he actually sick. After that, someday he can play, no problem. 1 or 2 days, maybe sickness. After that, the boy coming from school, the maid servant giving information to that boy, your pop is no more with you. Why? Mean? He cannot understand. He is not habituated. He is not, you know, habituated to hear this kind of thing. Death is one kind of a, you know, word is not known to him. He coming, he saying that lollipop not, he is already lying on a sack. You know, is calling, not responding, nothing. For a long time. Mother speaking, come, first take food, then you can go. No, first I can play. But that lollipop not responding. That boy almost gone half crazy. That boy was taken to doctor, he got big shock. Why? But actually, something happened? Yes, this thing happened. Half, almost half mad. See, this way, due to separation, we can go mad in this material world. But that madness is not appreciated. The more you have attraction in this material world, any objective, any man, the more you are feeling disease. But this case is just opposite. In transcendental world, just opposite the case is. Just opposite. If you are crying for Krishna all the time, very good. If I am crying for my Guru Maharaj or Guru Varga Gran, who can protect me, who can give me consolation, who can love me, I can remember. Guru Maharaj keeping my head here, and giving my mats on, so nice. Who can speak like that? Never my father, mother, never loved me that way. What I got from my, yes, I got this kind of love. I can never pay my Guru Maharaj. What I can see, I have nothing to pay. All the time I remember. You know, all the time joking with me, loving me, but I find none. After Guru Maharaj gone, I find nobody. I cannot find. Anyway, actually point is that this material separation going to put you into trouble. Material separation going to put you into trouble. The more you feel material separation, the more you are going deep into material ocean. But the case is just opposite in this transcendental world. If you feel separation for Guru Vaishnava, Supreme Lord, Very good. You can remember, that's why I told you. Gaur Kishore Baba speaking to that man. How you take nicely, enjoy brinjal fry and munger dal, rice, huh? All your property lost. Huh? What is this precious material? Krishna. We are losing Krishna. Krishna lost in our life. How we are leading our life so nicely? Huh? How possible? I know personally. One man in share market losing almost 80 lakhs. He heard the news actually. Heard the news. And at the same time, collapse. Heart collapse. 80 lakhs. Immediately he got information, he lost 80 lakhs in share market. Immediately heart collapse. Because the man thought matter and myself all same. Vishaya Shakta Chityanam. Money is all. Without money I cannot think anything. Money is all. But Ambarish Maharaj not so foolish. Ambarish Maharaj going to rule the whole world. But still feeling no attraction. Why? Is having bhakti. Why it is not possible for a husband to get control over his family? Full family. All his boys, you know, family members not going to obey him. Why? Whereas Parikshit Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj ruling the whole world. I am putting this question in form of this big scholar. Can you speak me the reason for why? Why they have so much power to rule the whole world, whereas you cannot get control over your own family? Only five members, maybe four members. Three members, I know three members. I know one master, mathematics master. He was very friendly with me from Bombay. He is Bengali, actually, person. He used to do service there in Bombay, Dadar. Someday he is crying in front of me, speaking all about his life history. He is speaking, Maharaj, my wife throw his chappal to me. Hey! My daughter throw chappal. You know, heel? Shoes to me. Why? Because I am devotee. They are feeling disturbance. They like to beat me. I know, in Damdam here, took initiation from my Guru Maharaj. His wife beating him with stick. He showed me all black. All black stick. What's that? My wife beat me. You don't speak? Well, no, I don't speak anything. Because I cannot beat him because I am Vaishnav. This is the condition. Still they are ready to lead their family life. They are getting some honey out of the family life. That master speaking me, he met me in Vrindavan. He was doing parikrama with me some. Long ago, I mean not now 30 years back. Maybe 25 years back, I cannot remember. Usually for parikrama I don't take anybody. Akela jaivo kimba songi ekjon, Mahaprabhu speaking. Sometimes some one pen I can take like-minded or sometime alone. Mahaprabhu speaking. I am going to Vrindavan. Prabhu, Nityananda Prabhu speaking. You take with me. I know everything. I know you. I cannot take you. I cannot take you. And Vrindavan parikrama, South Indian parikrama, oh, everything. Prabhu. Prabhu, you take somebody. No. I can go alone. A disturbance. So when I go to forest, I go alone, like madman. I can enjoy. If I give somebody Maharaj, I am very hungry. Where I can arrange? Not always possible this way. That master speaking, that Maharaj, someday my wife developed cancer. Cancer. She was admitted to hospital. such cancer, such a place, not possible to. Long ago, now cancerous disease treatment is more advanced at that time. My wife lying in bed, two times before going to school and coming back from school, two times I am coming, arranging prasadam, consolation, medicine, meeting doctor, everything. One day, doctor speak, she is not going to live anymore. Then somehow, my wife could know about this point, that I am going to die. In front of me, she bursted into tears and speaking and begging for apology. I have done all mistake. Please excuse me. You are my husband. I have done all wrong. I am getting same punishment, nice punishment. You have done right. You are doing Krishna bhajan, you are doing right. Last moment he confessed and go away from this material world. Until or unless we are going to get severe punishment, we bonded soul not ready to confess. So punishment is also one kind of blessing. I told you, na, my Guruma speaking, you see, Tidandi Bhikshu, he thinks it is one kind of blessing. I lost everything in former life. It's one kind of blessing. Whole day gone, he took sannyas, whole day gone, collecting rice and cooking at the bank of some river, cooking, offering to Krishna, going to take all, you know, wicked boys coming and making urine on his pot. But still he is silent. Because kaimon bakya, speech, punishment given to speech, body, shamo damo is called punishment. You have to control. Not that woman matajis cannot do. They will have to do also. For everybody. Those who are doing bhajan. If you do bhajan of Kali Devi, Durga, then I am not going to suggest you. But still you need restriction. Still you need restriction. If you have severe kama, you can get Durga darshan. No, not possible. Still, some sort of siddhi is there. No material siddhi. Yes. So you see, up to which point you will have to go up. Now you think over and again. So you see, in front of Kapilji, Mataji also crying. This way. So now actually you can now, by now you can realize that before separation, viraha is a common thing in this material world. Very often, we are having this opportunity to meet with viraha. But that viraha cannot deserve appreciation. But what kind of viraha? You see, that aprakita viraha can make you free from this material bondage. Be careful. That viraha can put you in the ocean of material, put you into misery, ocean of misery, but that viraha can make you free. That's why we are going to observe viraha of Guru Vaishnava. Sometime Bhaktivinoda Thakur disappearance, sometime Guru Vaishnava different. We are going to observe viraha tithi. And in as per Vaishnava philosophy, it's an excellent thing. Viraha tattva is excellent thing. What about aprakita Vaishnava tattva, Vaishnava philosophy, even material sahitya, writings, you know, big writer. They also describing about viraha tattva. Nal Damayanti in Mahabharata you can find. Why Prabhupada suggest you, Bhaktivinoda Thakur suggest you to go through Chaitanya Bhagavat? Why? Prabhupada never speak you go through Mahabharata. Why? What's the reason? Mahabharata, nice. It's all Jai Granta, Jai Granta, you know? Mahabharata, Ramayana, Jai Granta, Jai. Tato Jai Mudirat. Narayana Namaskita, Naranjaiva Nartam, Devim Swarasvatim Vyasam, Tato Jayam Udirat. Then we can Jai, we can say. What Jai mean? Victory, you can get victory over this material world. Joy. Ramayana, Mahabharata, all Jai Granta. But still, Prabhupada never suggested you can go through Mahabharata. Why? You can get confusion. Better you could, if you can go through the life history of Guru Vaishnava. It's more practical for you. If you go through the life history of Guru Vaishnava, then very quickly you can get that thing which we are trying to get long period you are not getting. Sutasapungsam suchira samasya, nanjosa survirita, that's the same thing. What we are going to get for a long period of time you are trying to get, going to memorize Shuti, Siti, every all, you know, Puran. But you are not getting a drop of nectar, prema. Very tough. That's why we find in Sara Goswami Stakam, Nana Sasto Vichara Naiko Nipuno, Saddharma Sangstapaku, Lokanam Hitakarino Tibubane, Manyo Saranyakaru. Why? Those Goswami, they have their power to start all authentic scripture and get cream for you. Very easy for you. Why you are taking trouble to fight here and there? Why? Unnecessary. Bhakti Mata get him very cream for us. Oh, starting Gita, Bhagavad, Vedanta. Bhakti Mata writing commentary on Vedanta that not published. So nice. You can go mad. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur, each and every step, wanted to describe the Namatattva. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to describe Namatattva, each and every sutra, formula of Vedanta, Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted. But it was not complete. Not published. But somehow we get Harinam Chintamani. Somehow, we are very lucky, we get Harinam Chintamani. Harinam Chintamani, in one sense, explanation of Nam Tattva, transcendental Nam Tattva. Still we are lucky. We are not going to get that thing that's missing. Who can publish? Where is that? Even the life history of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I wanted to get from Vrindavan. They are not giving me. But they love me, respect me. They told me it is there, I can collect and give you. It is there inside of them, but they don't give me. But somehow I was lucky to publish Chattoder Bhakti Vinod. When I came from Vrindavan, Navadvip Dham, I was lucky enough to publish the first book. First publication starting. With one book. And name is Chattoder Bhakti Vinod. Bhakti Vinod for those students. For them, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Chattoder Bhakti Vinod. So nice, very small book. Like almost very small life history of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I was lucky enough to publish that thing. So you see, so actually, Abhirbhav Tithi, Tidobhav Tithi, if you like to observe, then be careful. There should not be any dissatisfaction inside your heart. Still you can take participate, you can participate, you can get some kripa. But actually, 100% if you like to participate, in that case, there should not be any dissatisfaction. Follow what I mean to say. You can participate, you can take prasadam, you can hear harika, that's okay. But 100% if you like to take participate, then you will have to feel that thing. That Bhaktivinoda Thakur no more with us. Or through Bani Vaibhav, I can find Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur life history means his Siddhanta, his Acharan, all Bhaktivinoda Thakur we can in applied form. Aprakita Jivani. It's called transcendental life history. Nobody knows. Everybody think Bhaktivinoda Thakur took birth there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur's father name, mother name, went here. This is not. It's historical. It's okay. But actual life history, Guru Vaishnava like to get. What's that? What is Siddhanta? What is Tattva Siddhanta? Guru Vaishnava like to know his heart. That is called actual participation in Viraha Tattya or Avirbhav. Tirabhav. Guru Vaishnava arrange our Viraha Tithi. Guru Vaishnava, it is a system for a long time. Guru Vaishnava arrange Viraha Tithi. Why? Because Viraha Tithi can give us total blessing so that we can get free. Guru Vaishnava arranged this Viraha Tithi not to put us in trouble. Follow. Guru Vaishnava arranged this Viraha Tithi not to put us in trouble in the ocean of misery. Not that. Then, Viraha means some sort of, you know, suffering, miseries. Yes. Inside that kind of suffering have some nectarian feeling. I can give one example, you see. In your village, you arrange one Raman Gan. Raman Gan, you know, sing. Raman. Practical example. I myself, from childhood, I know. In city, they arrange one Raman Gan. That man, his name was Anath Bandhu. He can sing Raman's such a way, though you are material, if you have no enmity with Guru Vaishnava, though you are material, you can sit. He is not actually Vaishnava, but actually almost, you know, he is following some rules and rules. I was feeling that I already gone to Lop Kush, Ramchandra, already gone. I passed away there. When I was only 8 years, maybe 7, 8 years, I can feel. Today still I can remember. Oh, now I can think. That man is material man taking money. One night he can sing, he can take some money. But still singing so lucidly, so sweetly, that you are bound to cry. When Sita Devi going to forest, Ramchandra going to forest, Sita Devi was sent to exile, Ramchandra going to, ultimately after, when Sita Devi was sent to, and when Ramchandra, Sita, Lakshman going to, sent to exile, that time I was crying. And not me, or everybody crying. Even Gaurakrishna Babaji in front of God, that day he was speaking. One man coming from Bhagavad Gita, he is hearing Bhagavad Gita there. Babaji says, don't go there! Why? It's nice Harikatha there. Don't go there! Not Harikatha. Yes, Harikatha. They are actually rolling down on ground, shedding tears. It's nice Harikatha. Babaji, no! Not Harikatha. Only money, 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 money. It's not Harikatha. Don't go there. That place is totally contaminated. You will have to dig 20 feet mud from that place, contaminated, and throw, fill with new mud from Ganga. Oh my God. So Gaurakrishna Babaji knowing. But that man speaking, still they are crying. That man doing path, Harikatha, but all those common people, they don't know. Tattva Siddhanta, nothing, still they are crying. Why? And not only that, if next day, maybe next week, this kind of Ramayangan again going to take place, you can invite your friends and, you know, friend circle, come and watch. See, you can also enjoy. Why? Though you are crying, inside your crying have some nice feeling. I cannot say exactly as a nectarian feeling. I like nectarian feeling. Nectarian feeling only possible in transcendental world. Nectarian feeling only possible like Gopikas and, you know, Radharani, they are feeling when Krishna gone, when they are speaking, Tabakatham Ritam Tapta Jivanam Kovirizam Kalama Sapaham. That is called actually nectarian feeling. Actually, material people cannot say. Sometimes you can see Prabhupada crying, speaking Harikatha, somehow trying to check up his feeling, because material people there. Mahaprabhu also. When Mahaprabhu almost going to burst into tears, but somehow check up, because some material people there. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Bohiranga dekhiya Prabhu koilo bhav sangvaran. Bengali it is written. Bohiranga means external people. Mahaprabhu going to cry. Mahaprabhu almost going to burst into tears, but somehow check up. Why? Because external people there. In front of external people, you cannot show. You know. You can. That's why Mahaprabhu, Bohiranga dekhi Prabhu kohilo, bhav sangvaran. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati also doing this way. Sometime going to almost burst into tears, somehow check up. Because external people. Is one this kind of love affair, attraction is a secret property, you see? That's why Gaur Kesava point out, you are losing your property, vast power, everything lost. Why you are taking brinjal fry and muget dal so nicely and enjoying your life? Foolish. You are not crying. Everything lost in your life. Krishna lost. Eh? We should learn from Gaur Kishore Baba. We should learn from Prabhupada. We should learn from Gopikas. Oh, day and night they are crying. Krishna is not there. I can go deep into this philosophy. When Radharani meeting Krishna, they can crying more and more. Why? Krishna is there in front of you, but still crying more. Why? Now Krishna is there. Maybe next moment I can lose Krishna. Krishna is a precious jewel. Now I meet Krishna, I know. Why you are crying? Krishna is there in your lap. Oh, now Krishna is there. Maybe a fraction of a second. Krishna is there in lap. Where is Krishna? Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking. Uddhava, what to speak? Plum tree. You know? Plum tree. Only the color, just similar. Then plum tree embrace. I get Krishna. Plum tree, not Krishna. It's plum tree, not Krishna. Plum tree sometimes talbiksha, tamalbiksha sometimes. Tamalbiksha sometimes talbiksha. Tamalbiksha. Embrace and I get Krishna. Oh, I'm so happy. Is Krishna? It is a mood of, you know, separation, love. It's, you know, heavy. So you see, if you have sufficient kripa, if you are going to get sufficient kripa, because if you go through books and memorize, Gaur Kishore Baba speaking, someday Gaur Kishore Baba laughing and speaking, foolish people coming to me. Well, they can go to market and buy books, Ujjal Nirmal, this, that, they can get Raganuga Bhajan, they can learn, foolish. Gaur Kishore Baba you are speaking. They have money, they can go to market and buy books. But where can that ke Baba, where can that ke? Where from they can get Baba? That they can get, that they can go to market and cannot buy. They can buy books and memorize. But where from they can get Baba? Cannot get. So we will have to depend upon Guru Vaishnava, those who are having that kind of feeling. Otherwise not. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving this nice example in Jaiva Dharma. Two clouds in rainy season coming side by side, and when coming too close, then charge exchange, positive negative cation anion. Exchange of charge take place very fraction of second. Then one sound take place and lightning. Bhaktivinoda giving the exact example. Bhaktivinoda speaking like that example. Two clouds come close contact, then exchange of charges take place, then immediately flash and sound. Similarly, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you have the chance to serve a Rupanuga Sadhu, if you have the chance, you are lucky enough to meet a Rupanuga Sadhu, be sure, if you are not a cheater, 100% sincere, and following step, not jumping, be sure, today or tomorrow, you have the chance to serve that kind of Sadhu, surely you are going to get that kind of feeling. It's one kind of contagious disease. Disease. Bhaktivinoda Thakur feeling, it is called Prem Roga, contagious disease. You cannot buy from market. You can go and buy books, recite. No. Feeling is rare. Only feeling you can get from Guru Vaishnava, not from anywhere. In the name of Raganuga Bhajan, Rupanuga Bhajan, if you are running here and there, then maybe you can fall down. Who can say who is genuine, who is not? So it's very important thing actually. So Guru Vaishnava arranged Biraha Tithi to get some nectarian feeling. Suffering is of course there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is not there with us. Prabhupada is not there with us, gone, leaving us alone. We have that kind of separation. But still, we have the scope to go through Siddhanta, Tattva, Siddhanta, everything. That is their transcendental body, Bani Sharup. Transcendental body, Bani Sharup. We have the scope to go through that Bani Sharup. Kipaya Hari Kirtana Murti Dharam Dharani Varaharaka Gaura Janam Janakadika Vasala Snigda Padam Panamami Sada Prabhupada Padam. When Hari Kirtan, Hari Katha took the form, I am so idiot, foolish, I couldn't realize his name is Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Kipaya Hari Kirtana Murti Dharam. When Hari Kirtan took the Murti, transcendental body of Hari Kirtan, I couldn't understand. This is the actual Bani Sharupa Prabhupada. They're fighting with property, power, fighting. Oh, foolish. Big treasure waiting for you. You are very, very lucky. Very, very, very you are lucky that you are from Gaudiya Math. But you are very, very unlucky. Very, very unlucky. But you cannot touch that nectar. Srila Santa Goswami Maharaj used to give this example. Very nice. My son, very nice Padma Madhu, Lotus Madhu nectar you collect. Srila Santa Goswami Maharaj used to love me very much. He used to speak, my son, you collect honey, very nice honey, lotus honey. Very, this much is very costly. This much you cannot arrange. Very pure. You can find automatically honey is coming. You are putting into one, you know, glass jar, glass bottle. That smell going on, that you can find that all honey is coming. But they can come and lick. They can try to lick that honey, but they cannot get in touch with honey. Because honey is inside that bottle, which is made of glass. So Santa Goswami Maharaj used to give this nice example, so that common people, they have no, that kind of brain is not there with them, they can realize. My son, everybody trying to do bhajan, but they cannot get in touch with that exact thing, honey. Why? There is a gaping glass screen. There is a screen of Maya which cannot allow you to touch that nectar. There is possibility. There is possibility, 100% possibility. You can get, I promise, I am sitting in Vyasasan. I am not going to cheat you. But you cannot get it. Why? there is a gapping of Maya. Somehow, if you can go on doing bhajan sincerely, today or tomorrow, I promise you, you can get in touch with that nectar. Try to bear, try to reconcile. Maybe you are suffering, I know you are suffering. Still, you will have to bear, develop your enduring power. Maybe somebody doing operation. I am also suffering operation. Whole day and night, operation going on against me. Unnecessarily. Still, if I give reply, then I will have to break all this seva. I can give reply. I have channel, but I don't take advantage. Follow? Whole day and night, they like to torture me. Still I bear. Because I'll have to ultimately go that point. Let them go. It is, you know, positive point for me. Follow what I say. When totally negative point is there, if you can search positive point, that is called Vaikuntha Darshan. Follow my point. Totally negative situation. If you can see all positive, that means your darshan is Vaikuntha Darshan. Parambhuja Keshav Goswami also used to speak this thing. Though totally negative position, still if you can have the chance to see positively, then be sure your darshan is Vaikuntha Darshan. Always try to feel that you are not going to stay in this material world, which is most unstable. Maybe you have many, you know, huge amount of property, but property cannot give you security. I know one rich man, big rich man in Jalandhar. Whenever I reach Jalandhar, they like to invite me. I never go to any rich man's house. I never try to take prasadam there. Never. I don't like. After I get realization from my Guru Maharaj. But still they like to invite me. But the disciple of Bhaktivala Chittu Goswami Maharaj crying, I am bound to go. I go sit one place, dry place. I am not ready to take anything. Sometimes they cry, they speak that my sister, that Amit, his name is Amit. My sister developing brain cancer. If you can come and sing some glorious Bhagavatam, it's not possible actually. How possible? Well, in our house. Or why not in temple? Why you are? We can arrange all same thing, you know. I cannot stay in your palace. It's not possible. Maharaj, all separate. All same thing. It is all totally separate. Nobody can go to you. See, still I cannot stay. I can stay in stable anyway, I can think. They tried their best to give treatment. France, Italy, America, Switzerland, all there. But doctor speaking, it is out of control. You will have to depend upon one Supreme Lord. Depend upon Supreme Lord. No other way. Then they wanted to invite me and Bhaktivikan Bharati Maharaj. I say, Bhaktivedanta Bharati Maharaj can speak. Maharaj is old age actually. Maharaj can bless, sit in asan. You can see, by his blessing, you can go on speaking. I told, I can think about that. I cannot promise you. After some day, they told that girl dead, die. So why I am speaking the example? They are billions of dollars they have, money. Whenever they offer prasadam to you, they prasadam gold plate, gold bowl, gold glass, silver glass, they keep for sadhu. Follow? Golden or silver, they arrange, put. So rich man. But still, they cannot give full protection to that girl. So money is not all. When you can feel over and again that I am in the ocean of misery, because I am not going to get Krishna prema, which is the only property. My Chaitanya Mahaprabhu teaching us, na? Prem dhan bina betho doriddo jivan das kore beton more deho prem dhan. Only property is Krishna prema, nothing property. That property cannot give you protection. You will have to remember all the time, fraction of second, I am going to die, I am going to die, I am going to die, I am going to die. Like Parikshit Maharaj thinking, by the mercy of Sukhdev. Sukhdev, Sukhdev. Rajan, you go on thinking you are going to leave your body, now and then, any moment. Then you can feel detachment. Detachment is not, viraha is not so cheap. I can speak nicely, different sloka I can speak and feel what Rupa Goswami speaking, what Mahaprabhu speaking, what, you know, what Madhavendra Purva is, I can go on speaking. Maybe two, three, you know, Harikatha, I can go on speaking this. Still I am not satisfied. So all the time, Tvam tu rajan marishyeti achintaya. Hey Rajan, you think over and again that any time you are going to die. You are going to die, you are going to die, you are going to die, Rajan. Yes, yes, yes. But when the Bhagavad Katha is finished, then Sukhdev Goswami, Gurudev going on, Shishya, Shishya, Sat Shishya, Sat Guru, Sat Shishya, Paramahansa Guru, and paying Dandavat to Gurudev. Anugrihito asmi, kitarto asmi, bhavata yat kurunatmanaha, srabito yachame, anadi nidanam harim. Ah, you describe all nice thing, nectarian, you know, it's actually, you are getting nectar. So when Gurudev going on, then giving one thing, Rajan, Tvam tu marishe iti achinta. I told you first when I started Harikatha, Bhagavad Katha. But now I am going to speak you, Rajan, Tvam tu marishe pashubuddhi imam jahi. Tvam tu marishe pashubuddhi imam jahi. This is beastly conception. This is wildly conception, beastly conception. There you are going to die. Eh? But when you started Harikatha, Bhagavad Katha, you told the Maharaj and you go on thinking you are going to die? Yes, I told then. But now Bhagavad Katha is over, you listen? Yes. That's why I am speaking. Kitato smi, anugrito smi, bhavata karunatmanaha, sravito yachami, shakshat anadi nidanam harim. You are speaking about that Hari, nectarian blessing, you know. That's why I'm speaking. Parikshit Maharaj, don't think that you are going to die. Because spirit is never going to be destroyed. After hearing Bhagavad Katha, I cannot expect that you are going to die. Your body you can feel, you can throw your body someday. No, you cannot have that kind of feeling that you are going to die. Because in Gita, what do you read? Basang sijirnani yatha vihayo navani grinnati nado naro parani. Like one torn cloth, you are going to throw and get a new one. You put on new cloth. After when cloth is, you know, useless, you can throw it. Just like that. So Rajan, you are not going to die. If you now think that you are going to die, this is beastly conception, wildly conception. Try to live. Tvam tu rajan marishye pashubuddhi imam johi. This kind of conception you have to throw and cut and throw. You should cut and throw. Bibrishya jiva sayamayam apramatyo. I told you, na? Cut. Gana sina, one short of knowledge. So, the bondage is there, deep rooted. Somehow you have to cut this life. Don't miss this life. This life you have to do. Who can say next life you cannot get opportunity? Who can say? This time you are getting this opportunity. Next life, who can say you are not going to get this? So you will have to come out successful this life. Do or die. Do or die. Don't stop. Go on doing bhajan. Right from 3 o'clock, you go on doing bhajan. Don't take rest. Or at all, if you take rest, that should be also your bhajan. Guru Vaishnava, I am taking rest, that is also one kind of bhajan. Be careful. Be careful about that. So about Vihar Viraha Tattva, you can remember Haridas Thakur when gone. What kind of Viraha Rasa was there? You can remember. Again and again you can remember Viraha Tattva can back you. Viraha Tattva can push you up. Viraha Tattva is so excellent. Viraha Rasa can push you and put you up. Of excellent level. Very nice. Haridas Thakur Viraha Tattva, you can remember. It's so pathetic. Even Mahaprabhu crying, all devotees crying, they cannot stop crying. Mahaprabhu say, Mahaprabhu, even when Haridas Thakur took permission from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Prabhu, bless me. I think you are going to go away from this material world. You are going to stop your lila. But please bless me so that I am not going to see that kind of lila. Haridas Thakur speaking, in my mind I can see, I can feel that shortly you are going away, going to leave this material world. Lila. Mor mole noy tumi lila sangmoriba. More Mulaloy, I think, I feel inside my mind that you are going to leave this material world very shortly. But please bless me so that I cannot see that kind of Leela. Before you, I like to go away. Mahaprabhu crying, saying, why? Yeah, with you, I am enjoying so nice, you know. Sankirtan, this is a Prabhu. Countless jivatma there, tiny, like just like insects. Countless insects there in the material world like me. If one insect gone, what loss you can feel. Prabhu, don't speak like that. Please bless me so that I can go before you. Mahaprabhu speaking, I cannot bear your separation. Because everything I think with you. But still, you are always requesting me. I think Krishna can grant that thing. Krishna is very merciful. You are expecting that kind of, you know, Leela Sangbaran. So I think Krishna can grant you. After that, Haridas Thakur speaking that the moment I am going to leave my body, I need two things. One, I can watch your lotus mouth, Mukha Padma, and I can keep your lotus feet on my chest. This much begging. I never beg anything from you, Prabhu. This is my last, you know, final begging. I like to put your lotus feet on my chest and look your, you know, lotus mouth and my tongue can speak, Sri Krishna Chaitanya. With this Sri Krishna Chaitanya, this word, I like to leave this body. Please grant it. Just next day Mahaprabhu coming. Just next day. Mahaprabhu speaking, what happens, Haridas? Everything okay. But only I cannot fulfill my Harinam. Harinam quota is not completed my. You actually Siddha Mahatma, you are Namacharya. Why you are taking trouble? You can do Harinam less. No. Then Haridas Thakur was going to get the same blessings what he expected. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming, sitting in front of him, putting lotus feet and watching and mouth. See Krishna Chaitanya. Mahaprabhu started crying, taking the body, transcendental body, and dancing. Big Sankirtan,
big sankirtan going on. They are all crying, but still that kind of crying is always appreciated. We like to cry for Krishna. We like to cry for Vaishnava, but we cannot cry. That's why we are unlucky. Tathapi kandrak, tathapi krandami, shauhagya bharam, prakasitam, jag jad bangshi, vilasanan lokanam, vina, vibhormi, prana patanga kana vritha. Mahaprabhu speaking. I can discuss all this point. Haridas Thakur, you know, they take Haridas Thakur Mahaprabhu up to Shi, they're, you know, already taking, you know, giving water on the body of Haridas Thakur, and Mahaprabhu speaking, hey, oh, Shi, now you have become the topmost pilgrimage, holy place, because you get, yeah, today you are going to get the touch of Haridasa's lotus feet. Then, with own hand, digging samadhi, cave, putting Haridas Thakur, putting balu, sand, putting tulsi on samadhi, dancing, going to beg for Haridas Thakur Utsav there in Jagannath Mandir. I like to beg. One Utsav is there. Can you give me some Mahaprasadam? Sarup Gosai come, Prabhu, you go. All vendors, they are ready to give everything to Mahaprabhu. Who cannot give? Shakshat Parat Parakhileshwar. I beg for some Prasadam. I like to arrange one festival here. They all, everything, like to give everything. So this Karun Rasa, Biraha Rasa should touch. Very small, small thing, if you go on playing your head, never you can come out successful. I know, have some reason for you, you are suffering, but you should adjust. All, Prabhupada used to say, all proper adjustment. All proper adjustment means everything you should see to engage everything, all articles, everybody in Krishna Seva. Then you are successful. All your speech, body and mind, property, this room, your wife, husband, daughter, anything, what you have. You have to engage in Krishna Seva. Then, very shortly, you can feel viraha, viraha rasa. I can discuss more and more next day. Today is the disappearance day of Srisila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. Srisila Bhakti Kusum Saman Goswami Maharaj. At the same time, today is Mokshada Ekadashi. Vāñcā kalpataro sikhe pāsindu bhavaja patitānaṁ pāvane bhavishma bhyo namo.